Valentino Rossi is attacking Marco Simoncelli. That right leg that he broke just 6 weeks ago gets thrown out to help him come round turn one, but not able to do it.
Well, we're looking at Valentino Rossi at the moment. He's in fifth place, but by golly, he's battling hard with Andrejevic. So he's got to, because Simoncelli and Hayden are coming along as
and
well.
And Danny Pedrosa is looking to attack Lorenzo as well. You can see it at the top of the picture. First, Rossi does go through, and Rossi up into fourth position. Who'd have predicted this just a couple of weeks ago when we were at Barcelona, when it was a pipe dream he was going to even make Sachsenring? It's going to be pure guts and determination that's going to carry Rossi through.
And here comes Rossi once again up the inside. Now, can he make it stick this time round? Stoner pulls across, trying to find a way up the inside. No, he hasn't. Rossi is on the podium.
Stoner's going to come into the final corner and attack. Stoner goes through in turn 14. Across the line, Pedrosa wins. Lorenzo in second, but who will take third? It's Stoner. He played Rossi there because Rossi takes fourth.
Look at Valentino Rossi. He really, really means business in sixth place at the moment. Here comes Rossi up the inside of Denny Roberts, and he's got past him. Roberts has now moved, Rossi has now moved up into fifth place. Here comes Marco Melandri up the inside of Danny Pedrosa. Marco Melandri moves into second place. Both 250cc world champions, Valentino Rossi has also got past Makoto Tomada. They like that, Ben Tomada fight back immediately. Rossi now up into fourth place. Look out for the Italians. Melandri and Rossi are on the charge. Longing on Valentino Rossi up the inside of Hayden. Rossi takes over third place. The crowd go absolutely wild. He's not German. He may be Italian, but he's now in third place. It comes Rossi on the brakes up the inside. Not able to get through this time. Or has he got through? He has. Valentino Rossi has got through. I apologise. Valentino Rossi's got past Danny Pedrosa, who's up into second place. Rossi sizing up Marco Melandri's favourite overtaking point. Valentino Rossi leads the German Grand Prix here at the Sachsenring. What a victory for the world champion, Valentino Rossi, here in Germany.
Marcus is attacking Rossi up at Tremonto. Brave move, a late cut inside, and he's through.
Very aggressive again. Now Rossi's going to fight back side by side. They're going to come 260, 270 kilometres an hour, and Rossi back at him at Gavoni as they come through a six. And Marquez again up the inside. This time he's made it stick, which is Rossi a little bit wide. Rossi has to sit up. Go. Rossi lines him up through turn seven. Rossi fights back. He's well placed for Lequerto, and Rossi back into second place.
Yep. Back at the front. Rossi's now attacking. Now listen to the crowd go mad. Rossi leads at Misano.
For how long? That's the question.
And Lorenzo fights back immediately. Rossi back at it. This is a typical MotoGP race in the early stages. Side by side as they come out of Tremonto. They want to be careful, the two Yamaha runs. And Marquez thinking, well, let them get on with it. I'll just stay back there and see what happens. Valentino Rossi, one bend to go. The 35-year-old Italian is one in front of his home crowd. Rossi back on the top step of the podium. That doesn't make you catch your breath, nothing will.
Here comes Rossi though on the brakes on the inside. Into the southern loop goes Valentino Rossi into the lead. One lap to go. 3 years ago, Valentino Rossi battled for the title with Max Biaggi. 3 years ago at this track, he overtook Max Biaggi on the last lap of the race to win the world championship at Phillip Island. And now here today, he overtakes his only title rival, Sete Gibinau, on the last lap, but he runs it wide. The crowd are on the feet here. Gibinau's back in front. Half a lap to go. Sete Gibinau leads the Australian Grand Prix.
Oh, what a half lap here at Phillip Island. Gibinau back in front as they race up through Siberia. Rossi right on his tail. Everybody's on their feet. Rossi to win the world title. Gibinau, though, wants to win the Australian Grand Prix. They race along the top of the second and now break from behind. Rossi back in front. No. Gibinau still holds the advantage, but Rossi has the inside.
That's when Nicky Hayden took Sete Gibinau on the last lap this year. Rossi, though, gets it over the top of Lukey Heights and in front of Gibinau into the right-hander. Two corners to go now for Valentino Rossi to win the race and the title here. It's all going to come down to this final corner. The long left-hander, here's the first part of it, short straight, and then through the tight apex of the second part of this left-hander. Onto the gas they go. Through the second part, into the straight. Who's going to have the extra grunt as they come down the straight? It's Rossi on the Yamaha. He is the world champion. He is the winner of the Australian Grand Prix.
It'll be tough. Here we go. The two Hondas sandwiched in between them. The 9 times world champion and 7 times Assen winner, Valentino Rossi. Just one podium finish this season on his return to Yamaha, and that was in the first Grand Prix of the year under the floodlights in Qatar.
I reckon there's still 5 riders who will fancy their chances of finishing on the podium or even winning this race. At 2.6 seconds separates for Pedrosa from Crutchlow. Bradley's a further 1.5 seconds behind. Here comes Rossi now out of the ram, so Pedrosa's going to try and run it wide, but Rossi is going to go through and he's going to take the lead in the Dutch TT. And listen to the crowd, they stand on their feet in the grandstands as Rossi comes across the line in the lead.
Rossi chasing his first Grand Prix victory for almost 3 years. You can hear the crowd, they're clapping, they're cheering, they're urging him on. They cannot believe it. They cannot watch back in Valentino Rossi's garage. The doctor is back. He is chasing his 106th Grand Prix victory. He hasn't won a Grand Prix for over 2.5 years. He's half a lap away from getting back on the top step of the podium. The crowd are on their feet. Italy has stopped for 1 minute. Valentino Rossi wins here in Assen. He's back in business.
It looks as though Valentino Rossi is going to be lifting that World Championship trophy once again.
Well, if he does, he'll be the only second rider to regain the Premier Class title after 2 years. The last man to do it, well, the hero of his, the man we met at Misano not so long ago, Giacomo Agostini. That's the sort of company we're talking about. But what has this man done for motorcycle racing in the last decade? That Grand Prix debut in Malaysia, 1996. Since then, he's propelled MotoGP into a completely new era.
Never missed a race since he debuted. He's had a win at least every single season he's competed in the series as well. He's had endless victories, 69 of them so far. Could be 70 today in MotoGP, a new record, of course. 147 podiums from 206 starts in the whole of Grand Prix racing. That's just an incredible, incredible statistic. As Rossi has a little look around, see how far Stoner is behind. The day belongs to him.
Into victory corner for the very last time. We salute the 2008 MotoGP world champion, Valentino Rossi.
That's Rossi now back down to fourth place. Colin Edwards has gone through now as well, and Rossi is on his own here. This is a real test of Rossi's race here today. How can he respond to this? Has he got a problem, or, well, it seems to be something wrong there, doesn't it? Valentino Rossi running it straight into the chicane. And just about bring it back on. A few moments there in the last couple of laps for Rossi. Park Valentino Rossi with the fastest lap of the race so far. We wondered how he'd respond. There's your answer. A second, 2 seconds quicker than the men in front. A 147.875. And Rossi absolutely flying to get back in touch.
Flag just Goddard Bend remains for Valentino Rossi. His 7th win here at Donington Park. Valentino Rossi looks behind him. Nobody in sight. Soaking wet, stands up and says, thank you very much indeed.
They head up to the corkscrew for the first time, an attack from Rossi. Valentino Rossi goes through and leads in the US Grand Prix. Now, what can he do from this position? Stoner in second position, once more, around the outside, going up the Rahal straight. Unbelievable stuff from Casey Stoner. And Rossi comes straight back at the corkscrew. We haven't seen action like this as Rossi runs off track and pushes Stoner wide.
Valentino Rossi just said, the fastest lap of the race, and that's one of his fastest laps of the weekend on race tyres, a 122.046 for Valentino Rossi. I'm sure Stoner will just sit for a while, just have a watch of him, see where he can have the edge over Rossi, just study him, get in front of him. Going into turn through, he's through one more time. So Casey Stoner does make a move on the front straight, as we said. Rossi's going to try and get straight back underneath him, and Stoner's going to keep the bike stuck in there, isn't he? But Rossi sticks it right up underneath him straight away.
Here we go, here's Casey back, straight back underneath him. He's strong in this section.
Great stuff in turn three. Stoner goes through, but Rossi's hanging the
bike around the outside. Unbelievable. That was a really great riding from Rossi right there.
And lining up the last corner of the circuit.
Stoner runs it. He's off.
And he's going to run it wide and onto the gravel.
That
could be the end of the race.
He's gone down.
Casey Stoner has gone down. Well, Stoner in second position has gone down.
Still,
There's only been three circuits that Valentino Rossi hasn't ever won at, and this is one of them. The Valentino Rossi will take victory in the United States Grand Prix. A big old wheelie as he crosses the line. A brilliant, brilliant performance from the Passmaster, Valentino Rossi. And you can see how much he loves that one.
We ride with Jorge Lorenzo. 4.5 laps to go. Valentino Rossi closes right up on him. He now ride with Rossi. There's only one man in front of him. That's his teammate. It's Jorge Lorenzo. Will Rossi make the move here at turn 10?
Not this time round.
He's sizing him up all the time.
That's the place to do it. He's starting to pile on the pressure. He wants to be close to him now. So when they come down that home straight, he has a chance to attack one more time. If Yamaha want two riders fighting for the championship, that's the price they've got to pay.
The price we've got to pay is a fabulous MotoGP race.
Down the straight, Rossi's right in behind Lorenzo. Here comes Valentino Rossi. Three laps to go. Is that what we said?
Yeah, three laps to go. We go. Rossi should take the lead. He has it. Turn one. Valentino Rossi leads the way into turn one. What can Lorenzo do? The Rossi fans go absolutely wild here in Barcelona.
Now the hammer will go down from Rossi, but can Lorenzo stick with it? They've been saying in the papers, we haven't had an overtaking manoeuvre on the final lap in MotoGP since 2006. Can Lorenzo give us one of those moments now? Here he comes down the straight. Jorge Lorenzo's going to go through, and he's gone through Valentino Rossi. Is he going to take the lead? He does! Oh, look at him hanging off the bike through turn three. They head down to turn four.
Here comes Rossi up the inside. Rossi retakes the lead. Valentino Rossi, but now he's lost it again. Lorenzo leads the way. Rossi very, very close indeed. They plunge down the hill. We ride with Valentino Rossi. Lorenzo now into turn 13.
And Rossi's invented something in the final corner, but Lorenzo gets close to the back. And Rossi has beaten him.
What a motorcycle race. What a Grand Prix.
This is going to be a straight head-to-head between the two Italians, the great rivals, Valentino Rossi and Max Biaggi. And you can bet that Valentino Rossi wouldn't want it any other way.
It's between the two Italians. It's between the two biggest rivals in MotoGP racing. It's between Yamaha and Honda. It just does not get better. It doesn't get tighter than this. And who can ride the harder when the tyres start to wane? They come onto the back straight now. Here comes Biaggi on the brakes. Has he got up the inside of Rossi? He has. Max Biaggi takes the lead. Rossi relegated to second. He keeps his line, Max Biaggi. He's made his move. Rossi relegated to second. Five laps to go. It tightens up. Rossi goes through. There was an inch and Rossi's done it. And there's nothing Biaggi can do about it. They break for the left-hander. Rossi just a little bit out of shape, but somehow he hangs on to the Yamaha. One bend to go for the world champion. Rossi is going to do it. The checkered flag beckons the doctor. The checkered flag is shown. Valentino Rossi wins the Africa's Grand Prix from Yamaha and from Max Biaggi.
What a sensational performance. We're on board with him now, and I'm he's got a celebration lined up. He's absolutely exhausted. He can hardly believe it. And I tell you what, Nick, it almost looks as though he may be in tears there.
I think he may be in tears. I really do think. In fact, this is no ruse. This is no joke. I just don't think he can believe what he has done. And wasn't it fantastic as he kisses the fairing of the Yamaha to see him and Max Biaggi shake hands so warmly? I think perhaps the rivalry is over now. They both just got such enormous respect for each other.